Welcome to the Granville Federated Church on this wonderful and beautiful Sunday, the sixth Sunday of Easter. Did you know that you are blessed? You are blessed, I am blessed, and all of you all that are looking at us today, you and with us today, are blessed. We have some celebrations today, and we also have some prayer requests. We want to pray for Bonnie, Jim, Danny, Karen, MJ, Robert, the family of Bruce Berkowitz. We also want to celebrate another beautiful weekend, Kayla and her new baby girl. And also we want to pray for the high school seniors. Beautiful pictures as I was driving through. We saw all the pictures there. It is a beautiful day. People are out. And I believe that this is what the Lord really wants us to do, is to celebrate in spite of what we all are dealing with. God is still present. A moment of silence. Eternal God, as we pray today, we thank you for what you have done in our lives, and we thank you for the blessings that you have given us. We also lift those families up and mothers who are still dealing with this virus. And Lord, you know that you are with us, and we trust you. We trust your word, we trust your church, for we are present today on this Sunday to continue to praise your holy name. The church is not closed. The church is here, your prayers, your people. They need to hear your voice. Eternal Father, we thank you for the presence and all that we do and all that people plan to do. And we are reminded that we need you each and every day in our lives. Bless our first responders. Bless those farmers. Bless those that are doing those things that are so difficult, but they are there. Be with us now as we continue to pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. And in the prayer, it was Jesus taught his disciples to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive us our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
scripture for today is from John 14, verses 15 through 21. If you love me, keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another comforter, advocate, to help you and be with you forever. The Spirit of truth, the Word cannot accept him because it neither sees him or knows him. But you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Before long, the world will not see me anymore, but you will see me because I live. You also will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in the Father, and you are in me, and I am in you. Whatever has my commands and keep them is the one who loves me. The one who loves me will love my Father, and I too, Jesus, will love them and show myself to them. This morning, these are the farewell discourses of Jesus. Chapters 13 and 16 is a message of care. You have to care before you really can love. As Jesus prepares for his departure, the disciples are worried. They still want to hold on to him. And Jesus, in the 13th chapter, says to them, if you just keep my commandment and love one another, I believe things are going to be okay. You know, caring and loving is a hard thing because it requires a certain kind of discipline. Jesus talks about keep my commandments. He talks about this one particular commandment, love thy neighbor as thyself, one important commandment that binds us together. It is about relationships. And yet Jesus at the same time was with them for a long time, but very short time. He ate with them. They traveled together. They did things together. And yet at the same time, he tells them, if you love me. Can you imagine Jesus is preparing to go and they're wondering, what are you talking about, Jesus? If you love me. You know, Peter denied it three times and he said, well, if you love me. He wanted them really to learn how to be together. And in these discourses, Jesus continues all of these verses, you know, more than 20 verses. He's still explaining about the Father, how important the Father is, because he gets his authority from his Father. And his Father loves him. He says, me and my Father are one. If you've seen me, you've seen the Father. And can you imagine, sometimes it's hard to understand, how can you see the Father, and yet Jesus and I are one? He says, the Father and I are one. If you've seen me, you've seen the Father. Jesus says, if you love me. One of the greatest writers of all time, his name is Howard Thurman. He wrote in his book, Jesus and the Disinherited, these words. He said, Jesus defines the story of love as the neighbor telling the story of the Good Samaritan. With such honesty and great power, he depicts what happens when a man responds directly to human need. Across the barriers of class and race and condition. And Jesus is trying to get the disciples to understand that I am no longer going to be with you. But love is the strongest bond that we have. Love is that thing that binds us together when trouble comes, when things that we don't always understand that throws us out of balance. Love has a way of binding us together. And Jesus makes these two statements of promise. He says, keep my commandments. And we have to keep loving. This morning, the idea, if we care, we have to keep loving. The idea, if you care and keep on loving, the disciples are faced with caring for one another because there's trouble ahead. Things happen after Jesus leaves. Things happen that we do not know what tomorrow will bring, but through this love that he is commanding him to not to forget, that they are to have prayer for hearts and remember as Jesus is purely focused on his heavenly Father. Because his heavenly Father is the one that he looks to. And then he says, I'll leave you another comforter. In this story, we are reminded that even in the midst of this virus, even in the midst as the world, as all of us are trying to figure things out. But I'm reminded in Matthew 6, when Jesus prayed, and in that chapter he says, even the birds of the air, don't worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. If we love Jesus, we're able to keep his commandment of caring and loving for one another in spite of ourselves. If you and I love, it means that because Jesus loves his Father and his Father loves him. And the disciples, if they love Jesus, Jesus loves them and their Father loves them. Jesus himself was obedient. Obedient to the cause, obedient to God's directions, obedient to the basic things of life. But now that the disciples are in the world, they are to care for themselves. As a result, we are to care for each other. And the big question they ask, what is the church responsibility in the midst of what is going on now? It is the same responsibility. Love thy neighbor as thyself. It is the same responsibility to care for those who cannot care for themselves. It is the same responsibility for 1,000 or more years that we are to love thy neighbor as thyself. Love covers a multitude of hurt and pain and discomfort. There's something about love that binds us together. And I'm reminded of these words in verse 20. On that day you will realize that I am in the Father. And you are in me. And I am in you. Whoever has my commands and keep them is the one who loves me. That is the question of our times. That is the question of our times. As we see many people who are trying to find their way. It's wonderful to see people coming together, loving one another in the midst of conflict and pain and struggle. But that advocate, that comforter, is with us. Jesus says, I'm going to leave you another advocate a comforter, someone to guide you and to hold you. I have never left you. I will never leave you hopeless as an offer, but I will continue to love you and to hold you. Beloved, we are to keep his commands. Sometimes people wish they knew the future, what tomorrow will bring. But in all things we are to prepare, as Jesus says in that first several verses of the chapter, I go to prepare a place for you. God has chosen not to give us his knowledge, but to help us to know that there is a future. He alone knows what will happen, but he tells us all we need to know to prepare for the future. When we live by the standards of the law of God, it doesn't mean that our lives are perfect or we're better than anyone. It just says that we can handle our situations a little bit better. He will not leave us, will come to us. He will guide us, and he will be with us through it all. We need not fear. We don't need to know the future if we are just keep loving Jesus. I am reminded of these wonderful words. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Just because he first loved me, there is a name I love to hear, I love to sing, is worth it sounds like music in my ear. The sweetest name on earth. Oh, how I love Jesus. So often when I can't go to sleep at night and worried about the things of the world, I will whisper those words in the midst of the midnight hour, Jesus, Jesus. And all of a sudden, calm comes over me. There's a spirit that says, rest from your labor. And then I wake up and I say, thank you, Jesus. Yes, truly, he is that sweet. Only if you trust him, only if you love him, only if you hold to his commands. Yes, Jesus is your Savior. Just because he first loved me, it tells me of a what Savior's love who died to set men free. Let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you for the blessings of the day. You may not feel loved, but you are. May the God that rules and super rules guide you in all that you do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
the blessings of God be with you. May the joy of Christ continue to guide you. And may the love of Christ be with you now and forevermore. Amen.